Greetings! On the 13th day of our lamp journey, we are going to make this lamp, named Truncated Cuboctahedron. Now, if we talk about the maths behind it, then the lamp you see in my hands is truncated cuboctahedron. And this lamp is made using this cuboctahedron, which you might have heard of and has become quite famous as the Diwali candle in these days. This is also an Archimedean solid. So, if I divide each one of its sides into 1/3, and then if I cut each one of its vertices, then a truncated cube octahedron is formed. And now, the 12 vertices we see here will become squares. Because if I remove the vertex here equally, I will get a square. Similarly, if I look at these triangular faces, we will get a hexagon after cutting here. And now these squares that you see, if I chop it here, I will get an octagon, because four sides and four vertices or squares meet here to make an octagon. So you can see six faces here, and thus we will be getting six octagons here instead of these six faces. This here is also an Archimedean solid. Now, if we talk about the property of Archimedean solids, you will see that this structure is made up of regular polygons. The squares are regular, the hexagons here are regular, and even the octagons you see here, all sides are equal. If we observe at the vertices, we are getting an octagon, a square, and a hexagon. At every vertex, you'll get an octagon, a hexagon, and a square. This is the astonishing fact of all our Archimedean solids. So let us now look at the steps of setting up the bulb. In my hand, there is a small bulb of 15 watt and a wire which we can extend to our needful length. Now what we have done is that we have kept one flap open and I put the bulb inside this flap here. And the cutouts we have here, like the circle in the center, we can take out our wires from this cutout like this. And now I can fix the flap with glue and it's ready. Our 30-30 STEM episode tomorrow will be based upon these lamps only. So to know more about these lamps, please do connect with us at 2:30 tomorrow. Have a great day ahead.